Electronics cooling can be a real headache. Take Sharon, for instance. She's an engineer on the project Critical Path to release a new computer server for cloud computing. Sharon has tried one solution after another to cool the CPU and the server, with no success. And the project timeline? That's slipping. Then it dawns on her. Heat pipes might be her answer to the project recovery. She remembers reading articles in Qpedia Thermal E magazine on how to use heat pipes. She immediately gets to work. First, she finds the maximum airflow in the system. Then she finds the primary heat source. Then she measures the distance between the heat source and the airflow. To speed up her design, Sharon uses ATS's heat pipe selection tool on QATS.com. First, she enters which type of heat pipe to use, round or flat. She chooses flat for this application. She then enters the length, the wick type, the heat to be dissipated, the evaporator insertion length, the condenser length. Then she clicks Calculate. ATS's tool gives her heat pipe suggestions to jumpstart her design. To finish her design, she needs a condenser and an evaporator. A heat sink makes a good condenser, while a block of copper makes a good evaporator. Heat pipes got Sharon's project off the critical path and moving forward to production. What can heat pipes do for you? Learn more at QATS.com.